que ya está listo.
Hola, ¿cómo están? Bueno, seguimos aquí con Sam the Cooking Guy, o Sam el super cocinero, como le gusta que le digan.
Gracias,
la segunda parte. Tuvimos una conversación en el segmento anterior, nos platicó cómo empezó. Él tenía diferentes empleos en diferentes lugares, estaba en el biotech, hacía muchas cosas, pero no era feliz y decidió que quería hacer algo feliz. Empezó con un pequeño programa de viajando por el mundo, hasta que llegó a un lugar aquí en San Diego y se dio cuenta que había un programa de comida. Dijo, yo puedo hacerlo mejor. Su esposa le dijo, no puedes. Dijo, sí puedo. Y decidió hacer comida sencilla. La idea de lo que empezó a hacer es comida que puedas preparar y comértela, y no comida que veas y no te la puedes preparar. Y bueno, de ahí, los restos de historia, programas de televisión, Emmys, y pues una cara muy reconocida, tanto en San Diego como en muchos lugares de Tijuana, en la frontera. So I hope that's what I said is what happened.
It's perfect for me.
Thank
yes,
you
you're welcome. You're welcome.
Now you do a lot of philanthropic work.
I do.
Like you did something for Mama's Kitchen. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
So I've been involved with Mama's for I think eight or nine years. Oh, when they first came and they asked, I was like, yeah, I like the sound of it. I think it's a good organization. The more I was involved, the more I found out really what amazing work they do. Think about it. Three meals a day, 7 days a week, 365 days. I mean, it's crazy. And your body needs one thing really to fight a disease, nutritional sustenance, right? And they're giving it to people that don't have the energy to make it for themselves. It doesn't have to do with how much money you have. It has whether or not you're able to make your own food to help fight these diseases. They used to be HIV and AIDS. Now it's cancer, now it's a whole bunch of other things. Fortunately, the cancer and HIV numbers are going down.
And it's incredible because you can do something that's related to food that you love.
Of course.
And at the same time, help people and have the relationship. Now,
exactly.
Let me ask you another question. I see, I'm watching at you, I'm looking at your shirt. It says, no taco, más o menos, no tacos. Why, you don't like Mexican food, or qué pasa contigo?
Here's the thing. So I'm opening the middle of the summer, the end of June, we'll open in Little Italy, the Little Italy Food Hall.
Okay.
A food hall with six restaurants. One of them will be not tacos.
Okay.
Mine. It's my first time into the restaurant business. I'm starting slowly, small. But here's what it is. Here's what I've been saying. The last thing San Diego needed, especially from a Jewish guy from Canada, was another Mexican taco shop.
Okay.
We're 20 minutes from the best Mexican food in the world. San Diego has tons of Mexican restaurants. I didn't need to open another Mexican taco shop. So there'll be tacos, but there'll be tacos without Mexican components. No chorizo, no carne asada, no pollo asada, no carnitas, none of that. Meatloaf, pastrami with melted cheese, crispy onions, and an over easy egg.
In a taco. And you know what the part I like the most?
Yeah.
I mean, besides that it's very creative, I think.
Thank you.
I want to try it. Second, that you mentioned that you don't want to do tacos because you're 20 minutes from where...
Best food ever.
That's Tijuana, señoras y señores.
There's no question about it.
La mejor comida.
Look, I spend a lot of time trying to convince people here, go across the border. Go across the border. I say, be selfless. Just go for food because the food is amazing. In Tijuana, unbelievable. And then you get further down and the Valle de Guadalupe is ridiculously good. But go because the people are fantastic.
Yeah. Something else before you, because we run out of time.
Yeah.
No. Is something else you want to add before we just, you know, because I can see the producer. Yeah.
Here's the important thing. I want everybody, every Mexican person, when they meet somebody from America, tell them it's not pronounced Tijuana. It's pronounced Tijuana. I watch the news and I see these anchors. They're yesterday in Tijuana and I'm like,
it's
not
that. It's Tijuana.
It's Tijuana. There's no A. What are they doing?
Well,
they don't know.
Pero, we can start learning.
Together. I'll teach.
Entonces,
muchas gracias. Thank you.
Mucha suerte.
Sí.
Thank you for letting us talk to you.
My pleasure.
Espero que no sea la última vez. I hope it's not the last time.
No, I hope not
bueno,
either.
Pues, señores y señores, esto fue una plática corta con Sam, the cooking guy.